Hi guys, this is Basan. In this tutorial we are going to see how to write unit testing for our controller using Makito framework. Few of our group member request to make a video on same. So and this is the standard Max industry following it. So let's quickly start a small application on that. We'll write two method, one is post and another one is get. So for these two method we'll write the unit test and we'll run it. So let's start a small development on that. Create a Spring starter project. I am using here Spring Boot. Okay, now add the required dependency. I'm adding dev tools, temporary database, that is H2, and JPA and Lombok and wave. So we add all the required dependency. Now create our project. Okay, project imported. So first create the required package. Creating a package called model. Creating a package controller. And here I am not going to write the service layer. I am directly inject the repository in my controller. Make it DAO. Okay, model controller DAO. Okay, let's start. Create our model class. Let's name a model as employee. With few fields, employee ID, employee name and employee department. Okay, so as I added Lombok, I am not going to write setter getter manually. I will use the Lombok provided annotation. Okay. So as this is my model, I need to specify the annotation @entity, and I want to specify one primary key. So for that we need to annotate @id, and I want this id should be auto generated. So I am writing generated value. Okay. Similarly, create a response class, our custom response class with name, make it name response with few field, string message and boolean status, whether it is failing or we are getting the success result. So for that we'll mention the true and false. Okay, so here also I will use getter and setter annotation. And I am adding the all argument constructor, even no argument constructor. Okay, now let's create our repository database layer. Name it as employee repository. This should be one interface, and this interface should be extends from JPA repository. This type parameter we need to pass our model class name, and this serializable should be the primary key of our model class, that is our integer. Okay, already I have video on Spring Data JPA, so if anyone not aware on that, please go ahead and check that. Okay, now let's write our controller. Name it as employee controller, annotate at the rate rest controller. Okay, here I don't have any service, so I am directly injecting our repository here, employee repository. Repository use auto add. Okay, so write the method, one is the post and another one is the get method. Public, we want to return our custom object, response object. Okay, so write add employee method, give the employee as argument that will pass from our postman. We need to write at the rate request body annotation, import it. Okay, now just call repository dot save. Okay, and pass the employee object, and manually I am return some value. Message, give some meaningful message like this ID, auto generated ID that we don't know, that will be generated by our JPA. Okay, inserted, then this should be the boolean, so mention boolean dot true. Okay, and give the URL mapping. This is the post method, so I'm writing post mapping. Even you can mention the request mapping, and there you can mention the request method type, whether it is get, post, put, delete, but better to use directly the post mapping so that we no need to mention the method type. And give the URL, that is add employee. Okay, similarly write one more method, that is to get all employee. Okay, this should be the get method because it does not contain any request body. Now you need to call the repository dot find all method, then it will give us the list of employee. Then return our some custom message. Like record count. Return it list of employee. Okay. so that we can add the employee.size here. Okay, and same, write the boolean true. We didn't add any exception checking, else while we are getting the exception we can set it as false. Okay, and give the URL here as well. Get employees. Okay, and give one root URL. Like employee. Employee service. Okay. We are done with our development. Now we need to write the test case. We have the controller, we have the model, we have the persistence layer, that is the DAO. So now we need to write the our unit test using the mock MVC. So first let's inject the mock MVC. You can check the import. It provided by Spring Framework to integrate JUnit. Okay, now we need to inject the web application context so that it will interact to our controller. Okay, annotate at the red auto add. Now write a initialize method where we can initialize our mock MVC, like method name, setup, anything you can mention here. And I want to initialize this mock MVC before load my this class, so for that I should write the annotation before. It is provided by JUnit. Okay, so here we need to initialize our mock MVC. Mock MVC equal to context dot what is the method name, no, we need to use the mock MVC builder. Mock MVC builder is dot builders dot web app context setup. We need to pass our context, then dot build it. It will return the mock MVC. Now using this mock MVC we can call the perform method, that is post, put, what we need. Okay, now write the method for our post method, that is the add employee. Add employee test. Follow the proper naming convention and annotate this is at the red test. This also provided by JUnit. Okay, now create manually few employee object. We are not going to set the ID, as we mentioned there, it should be the auto generated. Just provide the name and department. Name is Vasant, and make the department IT. Okay, now we can't provide the raw object to the mock MVC. Even from postman also you can't provide the raw object of employee, so that we need to convert it as a JSON or string JSON format. So for that I am using here object mapper. People are using object mapper and JSON. One more class is there provided by the Google. So I am using here object mapper. So using this object mapper, I can convert my employee object to string. So string JSON request equal to object mapper dot, the method name also self-explanatory, write value as string. Add any object, it will convert you the JSON string. Okay, let's declare the throws, we are not going to handle anymore. Okay, now we need the one more parameter, that is the MVC result. It will give the, it will hit the controller and it will get the response in format of MVC result. Okay, so here we need to write mock MVC, resolve mock MVC, mock MVC dot perform. The method name is post, so I am mentioning here post. Okay, and give the URL. What is the URL of our post method? This is the root URL and second one is the add employee. Give the root URL, then add employee. This, we need to add the static import mock MVC request builders. Okay, then we need to give the content. Content is nothing, our JSON request. Okay, then we need to specify the content type. Our content type we are following here, media type JSON. JSON value. Okay, then here we need to mention and what we are expected. We are expected the status code is okay. Okay means 200 dot, what is that here? And expected it is something. For this also you need to add some static import, but let me try. Okay, yes, this for this also you need to add the static import. Is okay, fine. Then we need to return the this particular, it will also throw one exception that we need to throw it. Okay, now we got result in the format of raw data, so we need to get our exact string what we are getting. So string mention result content equal to result dot get response content as get content as string. Okay, so it return us the string. Now again we need to convert this string to our corresponding response what we are getting in our controller, that is the our custom response with two field, message and status. Okay, so we need to return response equal to object mapper dot read value, one more method which will helps to convert string to object. Read value, give the what is that, result content, the string response, and the exact class what you want it to map, that class type dot class. Okay, now this will give us the our actual response object. What controller returns us, it is the same. Now we need to write the assert statement to check whether it is working or not. Assert dot assert true. Okay, the boolean condition. Boolean condition, we have one boolean field in our response class, that is the status. Make it status. Okay, so we need to get that. We will get from this response dot is status equal to boolean dot true. When our test case will be execute, if my response dot is status, I am getting the success or true. If, and this is the my assigned value and this is my expected value, both are true, then it will return the valid test case. This is for the post method. Okay, so now let's test write for our get method. Same, I will copy paste. We need to change few of the things. Okay, get employees test, and here we don't want any request body, we are just giving the URL to get the response from DB. So this is also not required here, and this method type should be the get. Okay, import the static input for this and change the URL. What is our URL? That is the get employees. Okay, so change URL to this, and we don't have content here, so remove it. And what else you need to remove? Get and expected is okay. Return, let's return the string, and we are comparing it. Okay, fine. So we write test case for these two method for our controller. Add employee, get all employees. Okay, now let's run our application. Go to the class. Let's run a Java application. First, we'll test from our postman. If it is working, then we'll run our test case. HTTP localhost 8080. Okay, and this is the post method. Add the body. Body is our employee with field name. Name add something like Santosh, and add the department. Something like, okay, so let's test it. Yes, one inserted and our status is true. So let's return, add one more, because XYZ. Okay, now we only added two records. Let's check whether get is working or not. What is our URL for get? Get employees. Okay, so now hit the URL. We added two records, so showing record counts 2 and status equal to true. Okay, now already we have two records in our database, and we write our test case. So let's run our test case now. Run a JUnit test case. What is the error? Oh, this should be public. Now rerun. Get employees is success and this is add employees failing. What is the issue? What was 415? Let's see. Post content, content type value, content of string. Actually the issue was for this I added the wrong input statement and everything is same. So now let's try again. I tested, I got success now. So let's stop and restart again. Okay. Run a JUnit test. Here is the status of our unit test. We run 2, so all are success, no error, no failure. Run the 2 method, that is the add employee test and another one is the get employee test. So let me debug and let me show you how it going to the controller level. Let me debug for this. Okay. So once again let me remove if any debug point. Yeah. So let's see whether it is coming to the controller or not. Remove the breakpoint. Now run our application. Unit test debug as JUnit test. Yes, go to the debug mode. Okay, this is our add employee method. Press F6. Based on this URL it will go to the controller and find the same URL. If it found, then it will go to that particular method. Directly it will come to my controller, you can see here. Then from controller it will execute and whatever response it will get from our business flow, controller to service, service to DAO, it will return the same. Okay, so this is the way we need to write the unit test case for our application. Even few more tools are there instead of mock MVC, but people are using this maximum in industry. so you should follow. This is all about the marketer test using Spring. So if anyone have any concern and doubt, you can add a comment on video. So thanks for watching this video.